So, Travis and the gang were all apparently told 17 in March 2020, and nowhere in the drama alert was this mentioned or corrected. Noah wasn't told this information in the 9 months, or if he was, he didn't think it was important to bring up while Keem made comments about Minecraft. Bowblax received these DMs in November, and again, recently that gave credibility to information regarding Noah releasing the allegations. Here they were referred to as pedo allegations. They were not sent by Noah, and it makes me question who knew the age slash when. He then shows the DMs I received. The first one is from November 16th, 2020, where the person says, "I'm not allowed to leak or say anything, but expect certain pedo allegations coming out about a certain thick-necked individual in the coming months." A couple days before the allegations actually came out, the same person then DM'd me saying, "I can't say anything, but what I DM'd you a little bit ago about is currently trending. Get ready for the shit show that will be 2021. If you aren't already, turn notifications on for Noah Hugbox. That's all I'm allowed to say. Have a safe new year."
If anything, it just feels like a complete invasion of privacy for the sake of fucking views. And to make a successful YouTuber look bad for clout so guys like this can look good.
Hey there. You probably have no idea who the hell I am. And that's okay. My name's Narrator. Like, your dad comes into your room and he's like, reminding you, hey, do this and this and this, and you're like, okay, I got it. And then he gets mad at you, so he keeps like doing it and he keeps reminding you, and it makes you mad because it's like, I get it, and he gets annoying. And then eventually, like, you might just start yelling and shit like that. But like, that annoyance right there, multiply that by 1,000. And I'll never forget trying to fucking punch Alltrive to shut him up.
You serious?
A couple days later, Keem has more to say on the situation. He tweets out this Twitter video called, "Dear Good Guy Fitz and Caterino.
Y'all fucking stupid. So fucking stupid. Fitz, you were labeled as a horrible friend that slept with your friend's girl. Not true. Caterina, you were labeled as a serial whore, right? Not true. Fitz, you lost a year of your goddamn career. And God knows how much money. Caterina, you lost sponsors. You got kicked from an esports team. Dude, none of this bullshit was true. I reached out to both of you, trying to get you on my show, trying to do an interview. And I don't know what it is when I'm coming across a YouTuber that's like, I'm not going on there. I don't want to be involved in drama. These other motherfucking YouTubers aren't stupid like you. They'll come on my show. They'll say their piece. They'll defend themselves, or they'll give me a statement to read on Drama Alert. Because regardless of what motherfuckers say about me on the internet, I am the biggest fucking show on the goddamn planet when it comes to this drama internet shit. My megaphone is fucking 10 times bigger than all my competitors.
And then I ended up punching the wall. It's fine. It was a Motel 6 or like a shitty, one of those shitty like Econo Lodges. I did kind of try to fucking punch Alltrive. I get it. Whatever. Hey, Narrator's a horrible fucking person, but go subscribe. But he's awful. Go subscribe. I hate him with all my guts. But hey, my growing audience of hundreds of thousands of people a month at that point, because he hadn't gotten to 1 million yet. Go subscribe to him. Go subscribe. Go subscribe to this person that I fucking hate.
And like I said before, if there's anyone to blame, it's me. If I had not chosen to express my issues with Narrator, then the podcast would still be together. Now, I personally think Narrator's a terrible person, but that should not in any way affect how you see him. Please continue to support him and don't let any petty behind-the-scenes problems affect how you see us. This stuff happens to everyone. It just so happens that this is a very public friendship.
A person within a trusted position who has a large following is not supposed to engage in any type of relationship with someone under the age of 18. Does that bear anything in mind to this Carson situation, 19-year-old to 17-year-old? Maybe.
Why even bring it up if you're unsure or you don't have the balls to state your opinion?
Ha! Got it! Got it!
I am so sorry that you have to go a good amount of time without hearing my wonderful voice, but I think that these clips spliced together perfectly embody everything that I've been saying over the past, I don't know, 3 or so videos that I've made on this situation. Now, the clips were from Bowblax, my friend Steve the Libe, who had a very underrated video on this, very good video. Very base take, completely destroying Rebzilla, and whatever the fuck Rebzilla was trying to do for his little sympathy dance. we had that one little speech from Carson where, oh my god, what a terrible, terrible person. What a terrible person. Despite not liking someone, he tells them in a genuine fashion, mind you, to still subscribe to the person. Yeah, what a, oh my god. Terrible individual. Now, you need to understand the way narrator and Carson come off are vastly different. Whereas narrator comes off as some petty scorn little bitch, right? With a lot of things to hide. Carson comes off as more genuine and I dare I say a little more manly even compared to narrator. But, I mean, we're not gonna get into that. Point of the matter is these clips all perfectly embody what I've been saying this whole fucking time. Anybody that's against Carson is a fucking clout chasing scumbag, and not even the good kind of scumbag clout chaser, just the petty ones that are barely even men. Because I've said this before and I'll say it again, what the fuck happened to all the men? They're gone. Now we've been resorted to people like this. Right? People like Rebzilla, people like the narrator, who I'm sorry, I don't know. I think you go by Day, apparently. I don't particularly care. But as my good deed of the day, I'm sorry, I guess I'll call you Day, okay? There you go. You happy? Hopefully you don't become scorn and start to dislike me like you dislike Carson, because the last thing I need is a coordinated attack on me again. But if you want to go ahead and try, you wouldn't be the first, and I know you won't be the fucking last, buddy. But here's the thing. Compare me to Carson. I don't have the nice person image. I don't care about making your life difficult. I don't care about doing whatever it takes, because I'm not a nice person. I've said this before. I'm a mean, horrible person. But that's what makes me the most capable when it comes to dealing with terrible, trashy people like you. All in all, I think the clips got what point across. I think you understand it a little better now, right? I think my little speech right here is enough to hammer that point in as well. You guys are bitches. Simple and to the point. If you still can't understand it, I'm not wasting my time explaining it to you anymore. Because Sen doesn't run a damn charity case, and Sen doesn't run a damn special school. That's just the bottom line. Get it through your skulls, realize the fault, and come up with something better for me to refute. And just remember one last thing. If it wasn't for your constant whine fest, your bitch fest, if it wasn't, you know, if you guys could have acted like men just a little bit, then I would not be going so hard for a Carson defense. I would have just been like, whatever, this is drama that'll just be blown out. Even though you fucked up your narrative and your legitimacy early on, I would have let it go. But you guys had to keep, you're just like the left, right? The hardcore left, not even the moderate left. You know, I think Bowblax is a funny left-leaning person, right? I can put up with his shit, because I think he's funny and witty, and he doesn't push it down your throat, or shove it down your throat. But you guys, you're the classic example of, if you give them a little bit, they're gonna ask for more, and more, and more, and not even contribute a damn thing on their end. That is what you guys embody, and that's what I don't like. And that's when I will take a personal interest and making things for you difficult.